My name is Stephanie Kriegmer, and in 2010, I had the opportunity to go on my first mission trip. We went to Prosper, Haiti, and it was the most amazing trip, and it affected me in ways that I never saw coming. I absolutely fell in love with the people I met, and they have pieces of my heart I will probably never get back. Before my first trip to Haiti, I was asked a lot why I was going or why I felt like I needed to go. And my only answer was that it had to be a God thing. I had just graduated from college, I had no job, no money, and absolutely no business going on an expensive trip. Give me your eyes for just 1 second. Give me your eyes so I can see. Thankfully, I'm part of an amazing church, and through donations from our missions board, I was able to go on the trip, and I am forever thankful for the opportunity. Since my trips to Haiti, I've had people ask, why Haiti? Why not help people in America? Wouldn't you rather help people in your own backyard? And the first response that comes to mind is, how dare you? What makes you think that just because you and I were blessed enough to be born in this country that we are somehow more deserving of help from others? Then I realize that that's probably not the best approach, so I'll just say this. We are all created by the same Maker, and He loves us just the same. I believe we have a purpose in this life, and we all have a higher calling. Yours might just be in your own backyard. It may be in the next town over, or it may be with the orphans in Haiti. All I know is that my eyes have been opened, and there is no way I can ignore it. I read a blog post by the author of 1,000 Gifts, and she said, we all look into the face of the poor, and it's either yes, I will help, or no, I won't. There's no getting off the hook. That hit me right in the face while I was reading it, because while my experience in Haiti has affected me so much on the inside, it's been so easy for me just to jump right back into everyday life. We have an obligation to help those that we can, and I am continually turning away from those in need because it's uncomfortable, or it's inconvenient, and you know what? That's just not good enough. I am so blessed to be going on my third mission trip to Haiti this July. We have over 20 people going, and during one of our first meetings, I could not help but tear up. The first trip we took, there were only 6 of us, and I was the only girl. And it's so exciting to see that other people are excited about missions, and they're excited about Haiti. One of my favorite memories from my time spent in Haiti is how much the children wanted to be around us. We were there building houses for the people of Prosper, and as we moved into different locations with our supplies, before you knew it, there'd be a tiny hand taking your bucket or your paintbrush from you just so they could hold your hand. I've never had anyone, other than probably my mom, be so happy just because I showed up. I'm pretty sure I had a child's hand in each of mine the entire time I was there, and I wouldn't have had it any other way. I need $1,000 to cover the expenses for my trip. That includes everything from my plane ticket to the food and clean water while I'm on the ground in Haiti. And if I'm blessed enough to raise over $1,000, I would love to purchase supplies needed for the trip, as well as help any group members that are still trying to raise money for their way. I just want to thank anyone who is watching this for taking the time to listen to my story. It really means a lot to me, and I hope that it has touched you in some way.